Just look at all of these though, come on man, you can't say you don't like these textures here. I'll actually try to finish this texture somewhere soon, hopefully. Just kinda busy right now as to be expected, but I'll definitely work on it once I have time though, so don't worry guys, it's coming soon. I'm just not sure how soon. Man, you really don't see that many meat players around actually, that's kinda crazy. This lobby has two of them though, so maybe I'm wrong, but you know, from my experience, I haven't seen too many meats. Maybe I should use my meat sometime actually, I'm not sure about that though. I don't really have any cool meat setup. What's going on guys, I'm here. Welcome back to a brand new video on the channel. Welcome back to a brand new Mario Kart Wii video here on some more custom tracks. We're back here once again trying to show off the sneakster meta. The new meta 2020 is coming soon guys, believe me. In a few years everyone will be rocking the sneakster. You can see every single lobby filled with this vehicle right here. So you better get used to it if you know what I'm saying, right? You better get used to this now. Yo, acceleration! That wouldn't have happened right there if it wasn't for Sneakster 2020. I did get quite lucky there though, but that's what I mean, right? The acceleration stat, it does help you so much. I should honestly stop picking random too, it's not really working out. If you're using the mech bike, then sure, you know, you can play any track, but with the Sneakster, you kinda gotta make sure you pick your track strategically. As with some tracks, you literally just can't stand a chance, and if you pick the track yourself, it's just very dumb. Sometimes just unavoidable though, so you do gotta, you know, learn the tracks, but it's better for you to play on tracks that are better for yourself, your vehicle, if that makes sense. Here we go, Marble Towers. I don't think this track is too bad for the Sneakster, honestly. It's not the best, but there definitely aren't as many turns in this track where you lose time on, so that's actually quite good. This might actually be a Sneakster track saying that. And what I mean by that is not that the Sneakster is the best, you know, vehicle to use in this track here, but it is a very good option, though. I honestly don't think there are any tracks in this spec where the Sneakster is the best ultimate vehicle to use. It's more of like an all-round vehicle, right? You have acceleration, which is not that necessary, but it does help. You have high speed too, but you're not the fastest vehicle, so you know, you're not like the best, but you are kind of the best. It's kind of weird to explain, but it's like on time shows you always lose time, but online you have a much better chance. Like, the meta is kind of different, if that makes sense too. But that's why pick a random is so dumb though, because you can't pick tracks like Marble Towers then, as yeah, you pick a random. I think kind of this as well, like, if you want a front run using the Sneakster, it's just very hard. Because most of the times the tracks aren't too bad, it's just one or two turns where you can't really make it. Well, you can make it, but you lose so much time doing it to the point where you can't keep your front running going. For example, this track too is a very good track for the Sneakster. There's only one turn in here that you will lose a lot of time on. Oh, not another TC, dude. Oh my god, the 7th first lap as well. What? Oh my god. You know, small little details like that is what brings the Sneakster down, and it does kind of ruin the whole purpose of using it as well to some degree. And I mean, I'll still use the Sneakster myself no matter what happens. I know I've made too many videos on the vehicle already, but I love it, dude. I honestly think even if it's not the best, it is just a very fun vehicle to use, and it does give me a challenge. And the reason I say it like that is because I already have a hard time playing the game regularly. You know what I mean, right? It does give me an extra just thing to learn, as there isn't that much extra to learn using the Bowser bike or mech bike after you've learned just all the basic routes. I don't even think I'm in a position to say that as well. Like, I don't even know all the drift strats. Well, I do, but I can't do them consistently. I should probably get that on point first before talking about using a different vehicle. So yeah, I mean, here we go, we got 6th place. Not too bad, but it's not good though, right? It's definitely a middle position, which is kind of great. But in order to get consistent, you know, top placements, you do kind of need a tighter turning vehicle, which is kind of sad, but it's not impossible though. It's not like you can't win, but it's like you can't win consistently, as it is very much depending and dependent on the track that gets picked. So that's why I keep cycling back, and I'm talking in little circles here. You gotta pick your tracks, okay? That's mainly what it comes down to. You gotta pick your tracks and make sure you're being strategic about it. Now, obviously, as using the Sneakster, you kinda wanna pick the tracks where it's like, you know, long straightaways, less turns. For example, this track right there, I actually picked this track right there as well, so I can show you. And if I picked random here, then we probably would get some kinda, you know, dumb Mushroom Peaks kinda stuff, so it's good that we got this now. That is so mean, dude. Just standing still like that too. I mean, I gotta do what I gotta do though. But yeah, this track has this very large straightaway right there. You can just literally beat out any character, any vehicle, using at least Daisy, right? Using Daisy on this vehicle here. Now, the very reason I am saying Daisy is because Daisy is the only character using the Sneakster that is actually faster than Funky Kong Flame Runner, while driving a straight line, of course, right? I believe Peach is like a little bit slower, so that's the reason. And now, this slight little difference of speed between characters is not gonna change your outcome too much. But if you are playing on a track like this and you cannot run them, then why not, right? Why don't you pick the fastest character if you can actually be faster than your opponents. But that's the reason I love this track so much, though. This track literally screams straight away, so it is very good for this vehicle. As you can see right there, right, I'm in second place, I'm kind of breaking away, so yeah, you do gain time and you do go faster. And there it is, a beautiful front run second place. It's dope, man. At this point, I'm kind of getting obsessed with vehicles, well, it's kind of getting crazy, man. It's getting out of hand here, slowly but surely. I'm getting literally addicted to using the vehicle, so it's not going the right way, I don't think, but you need to dedicate, you know, to use this vehicle, which I do have it right now. I might lose it, and at one point, I almost lost it. It was, like, last week. I'm still a garbage can player, so I kind of got to step my game up a little bit still, but hey, I'm getting there, guys. And here we go as well, another beautiful track to show off the Sneakster's viability in this game. Now, the problem with this track for me kind of is that I don't know the exact routes that are the fastest, but that is just my own fault and problem, though, so I can't really blame anyone else for that. But look at this, I'm literally breaking away here, right? They can't go faster than me. They can't exceed my top speed, at least while I'm in a straightaway. They can't go faster by any means whatsoever. On different turns, then sure, they can definitely, you know, gain time on me that way, but on just straightaways, there's no chance anyone will be faster than you, except they're using the spear or something like that. But the spear is no other beast, so I'm not even gonna talk about the spear here. And I do think that's gonna do it for this video, though. Thank you guys so much for watching. I know we kinda got disconnected there at the end, but I hope you guys still enjoyed, though. If you enjoyed, drop a like down below, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Enjoy your stay.